more than 2 bits. Bits, 3 bits, 4, 8, any number of bits can be added. So basically it is constructed using a series of full adders then the last circuit, the last one or the one which is used for the least significant bit can be a half adder also, because the last one has only 2 bits, so for that you require only a half adder. For the remaining bits, you will be using full adders. For the remaining bits, we will be using full adders. So, what is the circuit that we are talking about? So, let me show you. Suppose you want to add, let us say, 2 bits at a time. Let us represent them as A0, A1, A2, A3, B0, B1, B2 and B3. This is one 4 bit. This is another 4 bit. If you want to add these two, what actually it will be doing? It will be doing a bitwise addition. Let us see what is meant by a bitwise addition. A bitwise addition is something like this. A0 plus B0 is added. Then A1 plus B1 is added. Then A2 plus B2 is added, then A3 plus B3 is added. So when you do this bitwise addition, actually what is happening is A0 plus B0 when you add, it will generate a sum, and that sum is represented by S0. There may be a carry to the next bit. So next C0. So first time, first step is A0 plus B0 or adding. So when you are adding A0 plus B0, A0 plus B0. It is generating S0 as the sum, C0 as the carry. So that sum is what you are writing here. Next step, the second step what we are using is, when you are using the second step, what are you adding? You are adding A1, you are adding A1 plus B1 plus there was a carry. All these three are added. This is generating S1 sum and C1 carry. So that C1 carry will be going here as C1. It will go as C1. And this sum is here S1. Now S2 and S3. So this carry will be from here to here is C2, and from here to here is C3. So the third step what we are using is, you are using A2 plus B2 plus, there was a carry, so C1, which generates a sum of S2 and maybe C2. Then the fourth step, you are adding A3 plus B3 plus, if there was any carry previously, then sum S3, C3. So C3 therefore is your, C3 becomes your, your C3 will become an overall carry. So this is how this is carried out like this. I'll draw once again. Now if I draw, you'll understand better. So now what we do is, let me take any example. I'm just erasing what is already written. Let me take a fresh new example. Okay. Created some space here. Now let me take a small example. Suppose I take, in this example, A0, A1, A2, A3. So let me take an example of adding something like 1100 plus 11100. By the regular addition, when you do, what will you get? When you add these bits separately, 0 plus 0 is 0, 0 plus 1 is 1. There is no carry, there was no carry here. This is zero carry. Here to here also there is no carry, zero. Now 1 plus 0 plus 1 is 1, 0. There is a carry. From here to here there is a carry. Now you are adding 1 plus 1 plus 1, which is 1 and 1. This is the final carry. This is your S0, this is your S1, S2 and S3. So what will you do? You will be constructing using, maybe I will take four rectangles, they are representing four full adders. Take one more. You can copy and paste also. Okay. Now, this is your least significant bit. So this can be even a half adder. So this will generate S0 sum, S1, S2 and S3. So what are the two bits that you are adding? Let me take two different colors. The blue ones indicate the first bit. So these are your A bits, these are your B bits. Let me check another color. This is your second bit. So this is B0, B1. B2, B3, a blue one. This is my A0, A1, A2, A3. Okay. So this will generate some carry here as C0. This is C1. This is C2. Final carry is C3. All these are, because you are adding, in this case, what are you adding? You are actually adding A0, B0, so it's only 1. When it comes here, you are adding C0 plus A1 plus B1. 3 bits are there, therefore you require a full adder. Here C1, A2, B2. Therefore here also you require a full adder. Here also you require a full adder. So what is your A0? A0 is 0. What is A1? A1 is also 0. A1 is 0. A2 is 1. A3 is 1. Now what are your B's? B0. B0 is 0. So 0 plus 0 you are adding. B1 is 1. So 1 plus 0. B2 is also 1. So 1 plus 1. And B3 is 1 plus 1. So 0 plus 0. Sum is 0. Carry is 0. 0 plus what was A1? A1 is 0. A1 is 0. So 0 plus 1 plus 0. So what are you getting? Sum is 1. Carry is 0. So here 1 plus 1, 1 plus 1, 1 plus 1 is sum 0, carry is 1. Here 1, 1, 1, so sum is 1, this carry is also 1 because 1 plus 1 plus 1 is 3. So what is the final answer? 1, 1, 0, 1, 0. This is your final answer. How do you verify this? So to verify this, what we do is, what is your, you are adding 1100, what is 1100, 12 in this, 10 or C in X. What is 1110, 1110 is 14 or is equal to E in X. So what is this number, 26 in base 10? Which is 16 ones are 16, 1A in hexadecimal. When you convert this into the binary, it is 1 1 0 1 0. Are they matching? So this is how you will be constructing the full adder.